code to appschallenge.mtn.com.gh and submit your idea to enter the competition now. You can enter as an individual or as a team, or a team to represent your senior high school or tertiary institution. It's a contest of ideas. Deadline for registration is 7th October 2016.
That we have this amount of users who are, that maybe say entertainment or sports. So maybe if you want to broadcast, you want to send an advertisement to people in a particular category, yeah. Then you pay $3 for 20 users. Okay, that's a starting rate. Mm. Okay, so it goes up, it depends. So what happens is when you go to our portal, okay, there is a portal for advertisement. Mm. So when you go to that portal, then you'll be able to determine.
Have you built the portal now?
It's still under development.
Right. Is somebody helping with them with the screencast?
I want a screencast from my phone.
Yes.
I can't see the device on.
Are you on the Wi-Fi?
Okay.
Okay. All right, because people are watching on TV and they do.
Okay. The app is Lean Business and Inventory Management app. Okay. So.
It's not inventory, but you let go.
Okay.
It's a customer, it's a CRM, it's not an inventory management system.
Thank you.
But yeah, so talk.
You suggested that we do some integrations. The last time when we came, we had a problem. When somebody makes a part payment, we couldn't take care of that. But we've gone to take care of that now. And
what else?
Yeah, basically that's what we've done since.
So, yeah, so what you've done,
We're also able to export now from, we can now, import Excel files into it.
Import Excel files?
Yeah.
What are you importing?
If you do your stock management with using Excel, you can import it here.
Okay. What else?
For now, that's what we've...
So the last time you came, you were saying something about selling it for 20 Ghana cities. Is that your...
No.
Has there been any refinement to the business?
Yes, we've gone to... review all those things.
Okay, so what's the new business model? How much are you looking to make over the next 6 months? How many users are you expecting on your platform over the next 6 months?
Okay, we realized that we can sell the app to users 150 Ghana cities.
150 Ghana cities per month per user, still unlimited users.
Yes.
Okay.
And
so over the next 6 months, how many customers do you want to have and how much revenue are you looking to have?
We projected that within a month, we should be able to get 42 users, those who will buy the app,
right,
who sell the app to.
So hold on, I'm seeing numbers behind this. Is that which time period? So the first year, you want to make 9,200. The first month, you want to make 9,200.
No, the first month, this is the...
expenditure.
The requirement, yeah, what we require to...
Okay, and how much are you going to make?
In the first month, we are going to be making a break-even. It's going to be more or less a loss.
You are in, yeah.
In the
you're not breaking even. You are in a negative. You haven't broken even.
Yes, that is
because... paid people.
That is because when you look at the...
So don't use the word wrongly. You haven't broken even.
All right.
Making a loss.
And in the first year, what are you looking to make?
In the first year, we'll be making... 41,000.
And how much is the expenditure? 44,000.
Yeah.
Okay, and then the second year?
No, actually, this is the profit we'll be getting. That is our expectation, the profit.
Oh, so how much revenue? You don't understand what I'm saying when I say revenue. How much revenue are you making the first
year? 85,000.
It's served bigger. Increases.
Yeah, this is the...
So 85,000 in the first year?
Yeah.
Okay, and then so you're making 40,000 the whole year?
Yeah, as a profit.
Okay, as profit. And then the next year is 122?
Yeah, 122,400.
Okay.
The profit will be around 70,000. That's our expectation.
So that's somebody, okay. That's
your percent increment over the years. What are you looking
at? We're looking at a 25% increment.
Okay. That's fine. Let's look
every
at your...
Every year you purchase or you're amortizing costs, your furniture, your equipment. What are you
they're
doing?
They're not doing amortization. They can't. They're buying new. They're just setting it up as new.
Yeah, we just...
Not proper.
So every year they buy a new one.
Yeah, it's not proper. But
so on our balance sheet, you will see that the cost they'll be reducing because we're going to be depreciating them. Depreciation will take effect of them.
Okay, show us in the code. You said you've made the part payment bit. Show us in the code the part payment bit. Also, we said something about linking your sales order to your invoice to your payments. Have you done that? But this also takes in account that your team still stays three people.
Come again.
Your budget stays, does it have employee cost in there? Did you say employee cost in there?
Yeah, it was there.
So three people all through the 3 years?
No.
Uh-huh.
For now, we are three working on the project currently, but then we are...
What's your budget in the first year for employee-related costs?
It's about 2,500.
For the whole year?
I think I have to go back and look at it.
You don't know your numbers?
I don't have it offered. Let me see.
Allowances, that's what you've written there.
Yeah, that is 30,000.
30,000 for the three of you the whole year, which is 10,000.
No, no, no. Yeah, we are looking at employing extra two hands.
So extra two hands, and yes, those so extra two hands plus those five people
yes, five.
At 30,000 in total for a whole year.
Yeah.
Year two, you are only at 3,600.
No, no, no. It's
year
36.
Two, for now, we are not paying salaries. We are looking for committed people where we'll be...
You are not paying salaries. Yes, I don't understand. So the three of you are going to what? Eat gari for the first year.
That's why we are calling it allowance.
Mm-hmm. We'll give ourselves allowance.
Yes, which is estimated at
5,000. So 10,000 a year divided... So 10,000 a year divided by 12. How much do you earn a month?
10,000.
You don't... But that's a number, right? So your number, you're saying...
Yeah, but even year two...
This will give
you're saying there are five people. Five people, 30,000. Is that what you're saying? Five people,
500 Ghana cedis.
Five people, 30,000, right? So that's what, 6,000 per annum per person. How much is that? So that's 6,000 divided by 12. That's how much you earn a month.
That's just easy. Okay, so go back to your code.
Go back to your code. You'll be answering the question and go.
3,600 there, so.
Uh-huh. So no, so work it out. You clearly.
You'll be doing the code.
That's fine. So you tell me. So 6,000 divided by 12, that's how much you make a year.
500 Ghana.
500 Ghana. So 500 Ghana per person in the team for over the next 3 years. That's what... No, no, it's per month, per person. But there hasn't been that much of an increase the next year. So for the next 3 years, you will be earning, each one of you will be earning 500 Ghana cedis a month. 550, 500, no more than 600.
You wrote 3,600 in fact.
It's a mistake in the
so 36,000. So
36,000. No, we just want to understand what you're projecting.
This increment. No, so basically.
Do you know? Do you know how much CRMs are sold standard? Like, have you investigated CRMs across in Ghana and who uses local CRMs and how much they cost?
No, they are creating a product first before they look for money.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, that's but then you own the business, right? Yeah. So if you earn 500, it's you. You just pray that.
Oh, but the two they are adding. But they are adding two people and saying that.
Yeah. So
which developer will you get for 500 Ghana cedis a month?
So those two people can be enjoying your 500, and you, since the business is yours. Like for me, for this kind of founder remuneration thing, it's normal for any bootstrapping business.
No, but they're adding two more people.
But then they are working with the notion that they'll be making more money. And then they can pay them.
No, but they are showing me their budget. And they are saying that even if you don't pay yourself, it's fine. I did 2 years, I did not pay myself. It's fine. But you're bringing two people. Which two people are you bringing? Which skill sets will you be bringing into the company? There's two groups of people that you're, two people you're bringing.
Okay. We want people, for example.
What skills are you looking for?
Professional programmers.
Professional programmers. You're going to get two professional programmers to come and work with you at 500.
One professional programmer
at 500 Ghana cedis a month. If you find them, let me know. No.
There isn't,
the quality developers at 500 Ghana cedis a month.
No, not really. The reason why we said that is because we are looking at somebody who is committed. For example, somebody who just graduated from programming school to join the
even at 500
national
you get
service at
national service.
Yeah, you can give
national service is now 500. It's now 650.
Yeah, but then
even that you won't
they
get.
Still take it anyway. So if you get national service and you give some equity or something, 500 is not a bad figure to give a founder.
Sorry,
person. It's not
for national even for national service.
See, a lot is happening at this level, getting people to work together for something small, and you'll be amazed of a lot of people living on such stipends, killing themselves for such.
No, it's different if you own the business. It's different if you, but you show us good. It's different that you own the. I disagree with this thing where you're at 600. Even I have had national service people are now at 650.
Recently, it's not. I don't think 500 is bad for someone that
competes
and joins your team to be.
Right, you walk us through the code.
Yeah. Around 120,000. This is whereby we're assuming that there will be five events whereby we'll have an average of 100 people paying around 20 CDs each. That's in our first year, whereby we're also looking at the cost of goods to be around
100 people paying 20. This is the. Sorry, who are your sales? These sales coming from 100 people paying 20. Who are these 100 people?
The people who are attending the events, turning up, the turn up of the events.
Okay, so this is from the ticketing, your percentage of the tickets.
Yeah.
At 20 CDs each, 100 people the first year.
Yeah.
So spending over the total of 12 months, is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay.
So then. We're looking at
what percentage of the tickets price you take? What's the percentage?
Taking a 10% for every
10%.
Yeah.
Okay, it's a bit steep. All right, and the people you've talked to are fine with 10% of the ticketing price, or are you just adding it on top of?
Currently, we are on the deal on the sales pipeline. Currently, what we are doing, we are discussing the.
So is it that my I know Silverbed is what 30 CDs or something, right? So is it that it's 30 plus your 3 CDs 10%, or it's 30 then they take 27 and you take 3?
If they're selling a ticket at that, the 30 includes our percentage because we are trying to generate traffic for the event.
Okay.
Wow. Yeah.
What are your customer acquisition costs? So if you want to find a new event, somebody who's running an event, do you have a sales cycle? Do you have a salesperson you've hired? Do you run ad campaigns? And how much does that cost to get one new event registered?
For an event, currently we in Kenya, it costs us $100 for the whole business expense for
to get one event set up, to find one person who's going to use your service.
I don't have that one calculated by now. Talking of the total business expenses, it cost us 100,000. At this moment, we are prospecting; it will cost us around 856
CDs to get 100 people.
These are in dollars.
It's $856 to get 100 acquisition of 100. So that's the marketing cost. No, the market, the customer acquisition cost. This is not per person. This is for all 100 people.
Not 100 people. This is for the whole for the whole year. For the whole year. This is a prospect for the whole year. 100 people is for a single event, and that one is
okay.
A.
Okay. All right. So it's okay. So your 856 is to get the events people. It's to sign up Silverbed, sign up all those people.
Yeah, and still acquire our users. On the other side of the mobile app, we have two users. We have the event and the people who are coming, the people we are selling tickets to.
Yeah, the number seems low. Okay, you just show us code.
Yeah.
Let's go through the code. The number seems seem quite low.
I was going back to see what I put back the last time. Are you sure the codes are coming back to
show us? Yeah, go back to the code and walk through. Okay. Did you explain the architecture of your code?
Yeah, it has been explained.
Do you have any questions here, or you're not on the, because it's a mess company?
It's not a mess company technically, but I would want to abstain.
Okay.
No, do feel free. You just don't vote.
Is that?
You don't vote.
If we want to do code review, sure.
Let's go into the code. Okay, I haven't looked at the code.
So this is API, this is a server, the server code, and now I'm doing several post requests. So to the database, which comes straight from the dashboard, and this is the dashboard.
I see how you store password.
Yeah?
How you store the user's password.
It is encrypted.
I want to see it in code.
This one.
I want to see it in code, not...
We want to see that it's hashed and that it's salted with a one-time salt, basically. Best practices.
But I think they're using bcrypt or something, so the salt is automatic, right?
Yeah.
Because of the format of the password I saw.
You're done, show us your assignments. Since we asked the people before on how they set up their permissions and authentication, yeah, we might as well show us.
Yeah.
What is it?
Yeah, I'm seeing.
Feel free to walk me through it.
So I have a module. I have a module, which I'm using. I'm using query string. That is a string. I want to look for string parsing. I'm also using session and compress.
No, I just want the password part. Don't walk password me through part. Everything. Starting from line 29.
So this is a module I've imported, require crypto. That is the one I'm using. A random byte 48. Then I store it in the token. Then I add it in the cookies. That's the cookie they are down. And the duration of the cookies.
You have 1 minute more.
Giselle.
You haven't said anything.
I'm not sure I get what's going on, and you're not explaining it well for me.
Looks like a copy and paste from the Kenyan thing to me.
No. The code they did for is Android, then there's Ben who did the back end, but I know how to do it also.
Why 48? Why the number 48?
48 is the bytes you are storing.
And that's what I'm asking, why 48?
You can choose any random number.
So why 48?
Because you're storing in 48, like the old after you convert it to ghost, like you're doing 48 numbers encryption, 48 numbers.
So what are you doing? Are you encrypting? Is that what you're doing over there?
No, this one, after you change the crypto, it produces random bytes.
And what do you use it for? What do you use that random string for?
The one we store in the token. It's the password then we store in the token, which it does.
For the session? That you use for the session or what?
Yeah.
What do you use that token for?
The token, it's to store the password in the cookie, so that when you come to the app and you add your password again, it will have a stored data.
I don't know if anybody sees it in there. Do you see it, Andrew?
I'm a little confused as well.
Yeah, I don't see how, this has nothing to do with the password the user is entering when they want to sign up, right? What I see over here is sort of like you're generating a random token that you want to use to identify me in my session, which is fine, but I wanted to see how you treat the password.
You save my password. So when I enter my card,
yeah.
Do you encrypt it? How do you, and when you encrypt it, where do you
send it? That's what I wanted to
see. I would have used BigCrypt, which I've not done with BigCrypt encryption. I should have used BigCrypt for encryption.
So the password is not encrypted, so what you're saying?
I copied code.
For now,
okay.
No, it's not a COVID code, but we did it, like the person who did it, not here.
We look at your permissions and authentication. How do you assign permissions? Show us the code in which you assign permissions.
For Android app.
For users. Let's see the front end for creating users in the system.
Who created the backend? Who did the coding?
It's called Brian.
It's called Brian?
Yeah.
And he's not here?
Did the Android app, yeah.
Okay.
That's a
challenge. You can't really find where it is?
I can't find it because I'm going through the code.
And where's Brian?
And if you can't find it, I mean,
okay.
It's fine. It makes more sense.
Now I understand what was going on.
You're just confused. We thought that you wrote the code, but you know, you went to sleep and you woke up in the morning. You forgot what you wrote. But it makes more sense that somebody else is responsible for that component. Therefore, you're not able to explain it as well as you could have if you wrote it yourself.
Okay. So let's see your Android code.
Many Java classes, but now after I get the API, the API up there, I've divided into three session events. There's events, there's free events, there's gigs, there's social event and networking event. I've also divided the movie session the same way. So different theater will be bringing different movies. So when they come, you go to the movie session, then you have a view of all your movies. So here is the code.
How do you upload content?
We upload through the website. Here. It automatically, because it's a JSON API, it automatically updates in the app. Yeah.
And Android, how do you deserialize the JSON? How do you turn the JSON into a plain old Java object? How do you go from JSON to something that's represented in the user interface?
So I used Google Voice to call the, then I've used several models. Let me show you the models. Like this one is one of the models.
Okay, so I think that you are onto something, like we're saying, but again, the energy and the pitching.
Yeah, the
messed company. We said that the last time. Okay? Yeah. You're selling off your concept and your idea. You must give me that energy for me to get into what you... Same.
You yeah. brought down the energy in the room.
Yeah.
Along with you.
Yeah.
Okay, guys.
All right, so...
Thank you.
Yeah. I want to make an input on this. As an event organizer, I would want to know how you get your users, on. First of all, because you've piloted this in Kenya, and it's working currently.
Yeah.
Yes. How do you get your event on? Is it automatically from the website or wherever? And two, I would also want to know why I should have my event on. Because if I have my event on there, how do I know how many people before the event say, I know, okay, you are going to get me this number of people from your end, and this is the percentage I'm giving you.
So,
because, you spoke about the National Stadium event. I don't know how you negotiate that. You have it on currently. And I want to know, do you go there to meet them? How do you get them? Because I'm also that organizer of that particular event, but I don't get calls from people like you. And you come here selling your event apps to me, and I don't get calls from you. So I don't know if automatically you let me know this is the number. I'm quite confused because the app is here. I don't get information from the owners of the app.
So currently,
I'm not using it.
No, for the people who are selling the tickets, we go to them and we sell personally. So that's where you identify the first five people, because those people have events like every weekend. Those people you identify are the people who organize a lot of events. So you're getting the first five, like the movie theaters, like the Silver Bird, you have talked to them, and we are going on with the negotiation and how we can have an offer for students. At mostly we are targeting University of Ghana. So after they give that offer to us, we are going to sell to the University of Ghana. We do mostly ad marketing through Facebook and Twitter, which acquire a lot of people. Like a lot of people, when you do those ad marketing, mostly in Facebook, we get a lot of people.
How many people do you have on right now?
Currently, we are just doing news acquisition. We acquire the movie theaters, Echo House, and Jamja. Those are the people we are currently having right now. Yeah.
So how do you intend to expand?
So we have two more to go, like the Bull House Entertainment, and we have the other one. And it's communication. We have two.
Right.
So we want the first five. Those five we have already discovered they have events mostly every weekend. So we have tickets almost every week. Now after you identify
the expense categorizations that you did, it didn't include. Because then that comes back to the $100 thing. So that includes going around and doing the marketing, or you're...
We have included transport for going to them, like identify each and every person. After that now, we have the... After you get all of those, and mostly we have offers and discount to check, currently negotiating with them. So for the start, because it's early stages, we want to go to the University of Ghana. We shall do mostly one-on-one marketing, which you know you can get almost like 500 people. After that, you can do our ad marketing, which you do through Facebook, and it actually works because you have done it before. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, guys.
Thank you.
We play games. Quick.
So as you can see, the supervisor has roles assessing the social content.
How do you create the supervisor? Is it an assign? Is that hard-coded within the system?
Pardon?
Is the supervisor's role hard-coded and you then assign it to a user?
No, it's not hard-coded.
Okay, so you take me to where you create the permission and assign the views and views.
Do you understand what she's trying to ask?
Yes, I understand.
Yeah.
Do you have a...
This is the same question I asked the other guy. Yes. Yeah.
Do you have a finite set of
roles? It's here.
Do You basically need an infinite.
Question, do you have a finite set of roles?
You can set up those things.
You have a finite.
So you can create, yes, keep creating and then change where they are.
So you don't have it?
I have it.
And then show us. Please.
Yes. So asking us, if you have an add role here, that you add roles, then remove role model, assuming...
Okay. How do you assign your permission your views and then the ad and add your crowd details for a view?
Okay. Each of the it's a role based system. Mm-hmm. So assuming you have access right page, and then you want it's one to many. So a supervisor can have different rights to different pages.
That's fine.
Okay.
But I'm saying show us how it's done. That's just all we're at.
Okay. So first of all, you create a role.
Mm-hmm.
Then you create an app module. The app modules are the different views that you want to access.
Mm-hmm.
Then you can assign a module to a role.
Okay.
Okay. And you can also remove.
Right. So you're not showing us in the code, no? You're just running through.
Okay. First one, add role.
I care about the assigning, not the add and remove. That's, I care about the assigning, not the add and remove.
Okay. Okay, this is it.
Okay. All right, so you've created your views and then you've just, okay, you assign them to. Anybody have any more questions here? Okay. All right. We didn't ask anything about business at all. So what's your revenue projections? What was your revenue projections over the last 12 months, over the next 12 months, your revenue projections?
Yes. Send me to the end. Let me see. What's
yeah. Okay. Sorry. We can't just. What's happening?
The cash flow.
Which one's. No. So, year one. It's really hard. Net cash flow for year one is what? 64,000 or 6,000?
64,000.
Which is what your profit is over the year?
Yes.
What's your team size like?
Okay, right now we are three. I'm the developer, and I have two support people that assist me with support.
Okay, what are your employee-related costs look like over the next 12 months?
Pardon me?
What does your employee-related costs look like over the next 12 months?
Okay. This currently, let me explain. Let me go through the cash. Okay. Currently, we have 34 sales guys.
Mm-hmm.
They pay 30 CDs a month.
Mm-hmm.
Now, over the for the next 3 months, we don't intend bring. There's no. I don't think.
30 cities a month.
Yes.
Yeah, for each user, so they sell it to a company and then per user and sign up. Yeah.
Okay. And I made mention of a major company that's bringing about 180, and I expect them to come on somewhere in April.
Mm-hmm.
And when they come on, they are going to pay a software licensing fee. So when you look at the figures, you see as at April it shoots up, and then for the subsequent months.
That was the same question.
The subsequent months, they are going to pay user fees for on each of them. Yes, so that's why he's like.
Okay.
What?
No, but you didn't answer the employee-related cost question, no?
Okay.
So basically, he has three workers. Is that what it
means? So it will be three workers over the next 12 months?
Over the next 12 months.
They're all on commission?
Pardon me?
They're all on commission. They're being paid as they bring you leads.
Yes. Mm. And let me say this. They are not, we don't pay each, because right now we don't have a lot of customers. The relationship is not that we don't pay much. But I expect that when the major one comes, then we can actually increase the salary a little bit.
Okay.
So basically this month you'll be our 1,610?
Yes.
I think the last time he was on the
phone. Yeah, okay.
You're still helping your mom's company out. That's what is giving you this returns. All right, I'm okay.
Okay, all right.
Thank you.
What's the name of the app again?
Nanti. As in what, walk?
Then the S is what, software? Nanti S.
It's just Nanti, yeah.
Okay, Thank you.
Thank you, too.
You hear from us.
Now, talk for 1 minute and enjoy free Facebook for the rest of the day. And you still only pay for the first minute. The rest is free. Dial *315# to sign up now. Terms and conditions apply. MTN, everywhere you go.
4G is non-stop music. It's sharing and entertainment without buffering. It's gaming with no lag and movies with full immersion. 4G is business without restrictions. It's also smarter money. It's learning beyond borders. Achievement without limits. And health for everyone. It's love, family, joy, and everything else. 4G is life. Get a 4G device today and live on the next level. MTN 4G. Hello, future.
MTN. Everywhere you go.